Tell me something. Growing up in Texas, moved to New York. From Texas to New York.
It was quite a switch from Texas.
Uh-huh.
And I was 16 at the time.
You went to see visit a cousin of yours.
I did. Mm-hmm.
And backstage, burlesque, was it?
One day after I arrived there, she was visiting a friend on the set of a Broadway show, Burlesque, with Bert Lahr. And Bert walked, I was sitting in a seat, and he walked down and he said, "Are you in show business?" And before I could open up my mouth, the guy next to me said, "Yes, she is."
Who was that?
That was it. He became my husband. But anyway, he said, "Do you dance?" And the guy said, "Yes, she can dance." Well, the guy that had to teach me to dance quit the business.
Uh-huh.
Believe me, I couldn't dance, but I did go in the chorus, and then he asked me to do a featured part in the show.
Uh-huh.
And then I went on to do another show with
him. Oh, God, he gets good.
That's aging me, isn't it?
No, it's not aging you.
No, aging.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
But you came to Hollywood, one of Universal's top starlets and all that starlet type of things. What happened in Hollywood at Universal? Tell me.
Well, in between that, I was a golfer. I was a trick shot golf artist. So that's what brought me to Hollywood.
Uh-huh.
I had to get out of Hollywood. I went to Vegas first, and I played a lot of golf there. There was a lot of betting going on. And then somebody saw me and said, "You should go to Hollywood."
Oh, is that what it was?
And I did.
Uh-huh.
And
you were a golf tripper?
Trick shot golfer.
What's
yeah.
that?
Hit a ball off somebody's face. I could hit a flagpole, one out of three, 150 yards out. I could hook it, slice it.
Really?
Do just about anything with it I wanted to.
You've been playing golf all your life?
No. Played 6 months, and I was taken out on the golf inside a golf school in New York.
Right.
Then I was taken out on a golf course, and I shot an 80 from the men's tee. Played barefoot and didn't know how to tee up the ball.
Looking at you, how did these men play golf by looking at you? Are you upset on their game at all?
That was good for me.
Was it good for you?
Young. Very good for me.
Beautiful. God.
Usually, it was hard for them to play with me.
Really.
Conrad Hilton quit on the third hole. Most men would quit by the ninth hole.
I want to see what happened at Universal when you came here to be one of the Hollywood top stars. I'd like them to see a picture of you right now.
Well, I did a lot of TV. And
I know. Let's see a picture. There you are. Good God, you're beautiful. Deanna Dors, look at you.
Anita, I did a picture with Deanna Dors.
Yeah. Look at this. Is that Anita Ekberg or not? Good. Universal must have loved you. This was in the 50s, right?
Yes, it was.
Oh, look how beautiful you are. Oh. And Marilyn Monroe and all these people. Tell me about Marilyn Monroe when you worked.
I
met her in New York.
I met Marilyn in New York. I had been going to the Actors Studio for quite a while. I was studying with Lee Strasberg.
Right.
I even studied with Lee in his home before he even got a studio.
Really?
And one day I had to do a scene, and I was real nervous, so I stopped by a little bar next to the studio.
Uh-huh.
So I look around, I think, I'm not going to get next to a guy that's going to aggravate me. I'll get near someone that is not going to bother me. So I look over, and here's this girl with the bright hair and the glasses and looked very subdued and very cute. I thought, I'll sit by her, which I did.
Right.
And so she looked at me, and she said, "Are you an actress?" And I said, "Yes."
Uh-huh.
She said, "Are you working with the Actors Studio?" I said,
right.
"Yes." She said, "Are you doing a scene today?" I said, "Yes." She said, "Would you like me to help you?" And I said, "Yes." Yeah. So she helped me do my scene, and we had a couple of wines, and then it came time for us to go in, and we went via the bathroom.
Right.
I went into the, you know what, and she stayed outside. When I came out, I didn't see her, and I thought, well, there was a blonde standing there trying to imitate Marilyn Monroe.
Right.
Oh, my God, I could do better than this.
Uh-huh.
So I go out, and just as I open the door, she goes, "Jeannie." And I look around, and I said, "Oh, my God, I don't believe it. I've been sitting with Marilyn Monroe all this time and had no idea." So she giggled,
uh-huh.
and we went inside. And from that day on, we were the
best
of friends. Talked all the time.
Did she have a lot of girlfriends?
No. No. She didn't trust women.
Well, how did she trust you, Jean?
Well, one of the reasons is that because I sat there, I liked her, we got along, she liked me, and I liked her without knowing it was Marilyn Monroe.
Did she have problems at that time when you were in New York living at the Actors Studio working and all that?
Well, she always had problems. It depends on what kind of problems we're talking about. Man problems?
No, life. Just life. Not just.
She was always, life was hard for her. Very complicated. Very. She was very complicated. Depressed. And she had happy moments and sad moments.
But then you came to Hollywood. You've been Universal's and MGM, starlet. I mean, you are a true starlet. Hollywood. That's what they call the Hollywood starlets. And you, the three outlaws. Tell me about the three outlaws with Bruce Bennett.
That was my first movie.
This was your first
movie? And the only thing I can remember about that is my love in the thing had to eat a big piece of chicken.
Uh-huh.
And then after we kissed, then we had to kiss madly, and the director said, cut and don't print.
Uh-huh.
I said, why? He said, because you've got a big piece of chicken on your lip.
Uh-huh.
That was my introduction to love scenes.
The Macambolins, Ceros, Trocadero. Tell me about Hollywood those days. Jeannie Carmen must have gone to the
clubs. That was pretty wild. I once rented Ceros to give a birthday party for my brother and I. We're twins. And I had every celebrity there that is imaginable. I had lots of dates. I dated Hugh O'Brien and Frank Sinatra and Elvis Presley. And
Lex Parker. Tell me about Lex Parker. I mean, the guy who Lex Parker up the tree. Come on.
Unfortunately, I guess I broke up Mike and Lana's marriage, unbeknownst to me. We were in Kanab, Utah. It was very boring there. I was living in his house. We never had an affair, but we became very good friends. We fished together. We were together.
Jeannie Carmen, you're sitting there telling me never had an affair or
not with just friends.
Just
friends.
Really? Like what? Like such good friends. Like Lex Barker. I mean, Lana Turner was married to him.
I know.
Wait. He was confident with you, or what?
Oh, yes. He liked Lana, and they got along, but he wasn't, and he loved her, but he wasn't in love with her. And she was so busy all the time, he really couldn't tell his problems to her. So, but we were like new kids.
Uh-huh.
So, she wouldn't go fishing with him.
Wasn't it tough for a girl like you to be a starlet here in Hollywood at that time? You're so beautiful and sexy and casting couches and all that. Were there a lot of casting couches at that time?
I never had that. A lot of girls said they did, but I was so naive that if they approached me, I probably didn't realize it. And I appeared to be aloof, so because of my shyness.
Why would you? Oh, you're shy.
Yeah, I was very shy.
So if a good.
So, but as covering my shyness, I didn't talk. I just looked. I walked around. I didn't go to many parties, actually. I was a one-on-one person. And I wasn't always at the parties. So I would do my reading and I would go.
So
I imagine I got approached without realizing it.
Was Hollywood tough then for a girl?
Not for me.
It wasn't.
I never went for a part, never left for a part. I just got them. I would be sitting someplace or hear about it from someone.
Was there a lot of drugs those days? Not really.
I don't remember any. No. I had drugs only once, and it was with the king of Belgium that I met. I shouldn't be saying that now. And I met him getting in Dallas, getting on a plane. The red carpet was out. I was late for the plane. They were rolling out the carpet. I said, wait for me.
Uh-huh.
So I got on the plane, went to the back, and there was the king, and I had no car. I'm waiting at the airport, and he said, I'll take you home. He first took me by Luella Parsons at a party. Then we went to his hotel. Another person was with me. And there we smoked pot for the first time. I haven't smoked it since, not before.
But there really wasn't a lot of drugs.
I didn't know about it at all.
Yeah.
If it was there, I was never involved in it. Never was asked to take it.
Sinatra, got to ask. No, that's your love. Come on, you and Sinatra. You dated secretly, up openly. Everything.
Openly, secretly, and otherwise.
You're his lady. Actually, one of his ladies.
For a long time. 7 years off.
7 years with Frank Sinatra.
Off and on, yes.
What kind of a guy?
Well, Frank, to me, was wonderful. He was warm and sweet and cuddly and nice. I guess he had a bad side, but I never saw it. Never saw him? No. In fact, but I was worse to him than he was to me. I mean, he was never mean to me. I was...
What do you mean you were worse? What?
Well, I was naughty. One time we were having dinner with 12 people, a lunch, I guess, at his restaurant. Mm-hmm. And Peter Hofford was sitting next to me, and I got bored. I said to Peter, isn't this the boringest bloody party you've ever been to? And okay. He said, yes, what shall we do about it? I said, I don't know. He said, go to the bathroom, meet me outside. Uh-huh. I did. We took Frank's limo, went to the Peter's beach house, and guess how long it took me to get back with Frank that time when he came out and found out I had left without him with his limo.
I see why Sinatra loves you, so we'll get a close-up of that. Look, Gene Carmen, good God, you must accept Hollywood. Except the whole town, really. Look at this. You're beautiful.
Well, if I hadn't been so shy, I could have done a lot of distracting.
You call yourself shy?
Not now.
How would a woman call herself shy looking like that?
Well, showing it and doing it is two different stories.
Was Marilyn shy?
Yes.
Was Marilyn Monroe really shy?
She was very afraid. She was very insecure. We both had a problem of being afraid, being insecure about our looks. Most of the time, we thought we were ugly.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Even today, if I get a close-up of my profile, I'll be depressed for hours.
Marilyn thought she was ugly.
There were times, only when she was totally, completely, and utterly made up into Marilyn Monroe, when she was Norma Jean, she thought she was ugly.
Was she a lonely little child?
Very lonely.
Like a little child?
Very lonely.
Was she?
A lonely older child. A lonely lady.
How about the Kennedys? Tell me about the Kennedys. She loved Bobby, or I think she loved Jack, didn't she?
No, she loved Bobby.
She did.
Jack was just...
to get there?
Yes, to get there. She liked him, and she wanted to be in that atmosphere.
Did she wanted to be the first lady?
Yes.
Is that what she wanted to be?
Yes.
Did she?
But she loved Bobby, too. She did. But she was looking forward to being the first lady because Bobby promised to marry her.
Ah, he promised to marry her?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to show this clip right now of Marilyn. It's incredible. I love it. Show it.
Fire to death.
No, 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 no!
In the closing months of her life, Marilyn Monroe was caught in an ever-tightening vice. The President of the United States had allegedly passed her on to his brother, Robert Kennedy. Robert Kennedy has cut her off at a time when he reportedly discussed affairs of state during pillow talk. She is labeled a security risk by the FBI. She is in constant contact with a ruthless mobster. She has in her possession an unexploded bomb, a tell-all red diary. Now, Marilyn hits back. Enraged, she issues an unnerving ultimatum to Bobby Kennedy. Her life is at the eye of a storm. It is now Saturday, August 4th, the last day of Marilyn's life. She desperately calls the Justice Department, searching the whereabouts of Bobby Kennedy. She calls her psychiatrist.
About the red book. What do you mean by the red book? The diary.
The diary? Yes, she had a diary. Yes. Yes.
She did?
Oh, yes, of course I did. She used to write in it all the time.
But not to be
ready. Oh, sure. But not to be malicious.
I see.
She was just keeping up with stuff that Bobby said, hoping to get more informed, hoping to be able to converse with him in a nicer, easier way. She kept everything, stuff about Papa, you name it.
And we saw her, too.
Oh, sure.
Peter and you and her were very, very close, the three of you.
Oh, yes.
Tell me about the affair between us. There was no sex affair. It was a friendship affair between you three.
Yes, there was never any sex. There was never, Peter never approached either one of us for sex, ever. And we were all good friends. We spent a great deal of time.
Three girlfriends.
That's probably what it was. Because we used to sit around and say, why doesn't he ever make a play for us? There were times when we thought something was wrong with us, and then we'd take a look and say, well, there must be something wrong with Peter. But we adored him. He was so cute.
Kind of
cute.
He took drugs.
But not in the beginning, not when we were friends with him. He never took drugs. He took it after her death.
After her death?
I'm sure he was involved in that, and he just went down the tube.
What do you think about the Kennedys and Marilyn, Bobby Kennedy? She really wanted to be the first lady. What do you think happened that night? Because you spoke to her just before, what, Before her death is
around 9:30.
9:30?
Uh-huh.
And she died when?
Well, they put it between 12 and 3.
God, just like an hour, 2 hours mm-hmm. before?
And
how was her voice at that time?
She sounded fine. She was, the week before, she'd been very nervous because she'd been getting a lot of crazy phone calls from a woman calling her all kinds of dirty names.
Some woman?
Yes. And she could, she thought she knew, I mean, she recognized the voice, but she couldn't put a name on it. And she was nervous about that, but she had no sleeping pills when I talked to her because she was as clear as a bell. So, and where did she get them? She couldn't have them.
You believe she was murdered?
Oh, I absolutely think she was murdered.
Saying that word, absolutely, so quickly. Jeannie Carmen, you're sitting there telling me you believe Marilyn Monroe has been murdered.
Mm-hmm.
You don't think she overdosed and forgot?
What was she overdosed with? She had nothing to overdose with. She called me for sleeping pills.
So you gave her some sleeping pills?
No, I didn't. I didn't.
She used to call.
I didn't have any. I used to, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she gave me pills. I gave her pills. We were both addicted to sleeping pills.
Did she tell you a lot of her secrets, that nobody knows out there about her?
How yes, but you're going to have to get that from
that's me.
I finally decided to write a book.
Hey, I love this picture of you. It's dark hair. Look sexy. Good God. Wild Animal. I love that. What movie was that in? That was a wild film.
I can't remember.
I think it was Untamed. Can you do a movie with Mamie Van Doren?
What yes, I did. Untamed You.
Untamed You.
And there was another one. I can't even remember.
You're the Prince of Mamie Van Doren.
Oh,
Jane and Phil, all these people.
No, Jane, I only met a few times.
Uh-huh.
A few times.
This is great. Look at this. I
love the one that reminds me of Diana Duras. I think that is from the picture that I did with Diana Duras.
What was that? Tell me about that. You did a movie with her, and she saw you in the picture.
I know. She cut me out of it.
She saw this, and she cut you out.
Yeah.
Is this the script number like?
Yes.
The script number?
Yes.
Good God, Jane Carmen. You studied acting at Actors Studio.
Yes.
Sex personified. You want it really to be an in-depth actress, didn't you?
I want to be a good actress, yes. Uh-huh. I'm very dramatic.
Did Marilyn Monroe want it to be a good actress? I thought
she was. Oh, yes. And once she started going at the actress to the actress studio, she was so much better.
What
she had improved 100%.
You saw it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, unbelievable how much
she did you see her in the later part of the years when Misfit and all that? Were you close with her?
Was I was still
at the set Clark Gable and all that?
Yes, I
was. You were telling me about Clark Gable. He was a man.
I was still friends with Clark Gable while they were doing the Misfits.
Uh-huh. He was a man's drinker, wasn't he?
He was the worst.
Really?
He drank a lot. Uh-huh. He had to drink because everybody wanted him to be Red Butler, and he wasn't. So he would drink to be Red Butler. Uh-huh. Then he would be less Red Butler than anybody in the world.
Did Marilyn ever tell you that she would? There's a role that she would love to do? Did she ever say, Jeannie, I would love to do this role. I'd love to get this role. Anything secret that she didn't tell you?
No, she used to talk about wanting to do a lot of things.
She was a Gemini.
I know.
A Gemini.
I know, one of the few that I get along with.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But
I had a lot of Gemini friends.
But tell me about
she always wanted to study Shakespeare.
Oh, she did?
Uh-huh. So I said, go for it.
One choker.
Yeah.
Choker.
Oh, yes.
With Lawrence Olivia.
Yes.
That was one of my
She
things.
Wanted to stay in London and learn Shakespeare.
Were you with her in London at the time?
No, I wasn't.
Did she call you from London?
Oh, yes. Sure. Oh.
She was happy to work with
She was very happy, but very nervous because she was working with the god of actors.
Uh-huh.
So she was extremely nervous. She used to throw up and everything.
You sang, you danced.
Well, I've danced and I've sung in pictures. I mean, I've sang in nightclubs uh-huh. under the name of Sava Duro.
Uh-huh.
I changed my name just in case I was even worse than I thought I was.
Has your life ever been threatened because what you are saying sometimes about the Kennedys or any of the...
Yes.
Has it been threatened?
Yes, that's why I didn't talk for 20 years. It definitely was threatened. And also, when I was with Peter Lawford, there was a certain point
right.
where, after he married Pat, that I got a phone call from his Chicago lawyer, not from a Chicago lawyer, the one that called Sammy Davis and told him that stop seeing whoever he was seeing. And he said, you stop seeing Peter or you'll be sorry. And I quit seeing Peter for a long time. I talked to him on the phone, but I stopped seeing him. Because I knew what the Kennedys could and would do.
I see. You believe that?
I know it. I don't only believe it. I know
I can't
people
accept that right now,
too.
Sitting here coming from you. I really can't. Because the Kennedys, to me, are, I don't know, I just can't accept it. I understand what you're trying to say.
They were monsters.
They were. Mm-hmm. Well, Peter Lawford and his wife married, the last one.
Look how they treated him after Marilyn died.
Right. Sinatra just
treated him.
Sinatra didn't come to the funeral.
No.
Sinatra didn't call him at the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
In fact, Sinatra had him thrown out of a nightclub in Vegas that he was playing in.
Why does Sinatra hate Peter Lawford so much? Because
I don't know, but I know when Peter's come, when the Sinatra's against you, and there's nothing he won't do to embarrass you. I mean, I hate to face him right now because he asked me to marry him, and I said, no, I'm marrying somebody else.
Sinatra asked you to marry him?
Yes. So I would hate to face him. He probably would be rude, ignore me, or whatever.
Why did
one time he ignored me, and that's after I took the limo.
Why did Jeanne Carmen refuse Sinatra?
Well, he was older, much older. At the time, I was younger. Kind of a kid. He was boring, because when you're young and they're older,
right. They're
boring. His life was not terribly exciting. I'd go down there, and we'd sit on the pool for hours and do nothing.
Uh-huh.
And I would always make excuses to leave.
So you get married. You married a wonderful man who said, hire her. Is that the same husband?
I wouldn't say he was that wonderful, but...
But you married. And you have two children?
He's a football player, and I...
Was he a football player?
Yeah, Penn State.
Uh-huh.
And,
How many children were there?
Three.
Three children.
Mm-hmm.
Actors in the business?
Actor. Well, one is not an actor.
Uh-huh.
The beautiful one that you met the other day.
Yes.
And
she's
my, my two daughter and my son are acting.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
It just comes down.
Jeanne Carmen, what's new and exciting right now in your life? Living in Newport Beach, I know. But you're writing this
book? I'm writing the book, finally.
And what
and
title did you have to come up with?
I haven't come up with the title yet, so I've got to wait until I finish it. I'm hoping to get it out by the 30th anniversary of Marilyn's death, which is next August.
I want to ask you, why is Marilyn Monroe's been dead so long? Why is everybody keeping her up so?
It's
James Dean, Marilyn Monroe, these two.
And Elvis.
Elvis, yeah, these three. But I'm just saying, I can't accept that. I thought Marilyn was great, fine. But why is her image lasting?
Because they died at their peak. They died when they were young and beautiful. People hadn't gotten enough of them. They don't want to let go. They can't imagine these people being old and decrepit or senile or any of the things that happens when you get old.
Right. Marilyn never knew that she was that famous at that time when you girls were going out together.
Not at all.
She really didn't, did she?
Mm-mm.
She didn't take herself seriously.
Not at all. I felt like I was just with another girl. I was with a big girl.
Really? Tell me about the white convertible. You and Marilyn used to get in and go to the beach, and you were driving, and Kennedys, and Peter. Tell me about that incident.
You mean the one with Bobby
Kennedy. Tell me about that.
Well, Marilyn and I used to take massages, and Jack Benny took massages from the same people, facials from the same people that we did. Well, we all got friendly, and we'd go to the steam bath and stuff like that. Well, somehow, we would go out, when we'd go out with Jack Benny, we'd put the beard and the goatee and everything on him and a hat and stuff, so they wouldn't know we were in a steam bath with Jack Benny. Well, we told Bobby about this, and he said, oh, you could not ever do that with Jack Benny or anybody. We said, we could do it with you.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'll take that challenge. So we put the mustache, the beard, the goatee, the hat, the sunglasses on. We got in my convertible. They sat in the back. They hugged, kissed. She had her black wig on and her sunglasses.
Right. No one knew.
People would look. They would just look as if they were silly kids. And we drove to the beach, went skinny dipping. Came back.
Nobody dipping. You found the new beach.
Mm-hmm.
Malibu?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. What kind of guy was Robert Kennedy Jones.
Sweet. When I saw that, sweet, nice, really wonderful. Except I saw that bad side of Bobby one time, and that's when he picked up the red diary.
He picked it up?
Marilyn was in the bathroom, wiping up the shower. He picked up, it was on the table, he picked it up, he thumbed through it, and he got really angry. He got red faced, and he was swelling. His face was swelling. And when she came up, he threw the diary on the table and he says, get rid of this. What is this? What are you doing this for? And it was right after that he disconnected his telephone.
He disconnected? She used to call him?
She couldn't.
Never answer his phone?
That's right. At that point. So that's why she was going to go to the press on Monday and tell the press that she'd had this long affair with him.
She was going to reveal that she had an affair.
That's right. Peter begged not to.
But it never got out.
No, because they all died on Sunday.
Now all these years. And you still believe, sitting there, Jeanne Carmen, that the Kennedys had something to do.
Oh, absolutely, positively. No doubt in my mind. Bobby was in town that night.
Mm-hmm.
He landed at near Peter Lawford's house on the beach with helicopters. Oh, helicopter.
Number one golfer to the entertainers. Come on, I want to go back. Let's go back to that. I love it. You taught a lot of stars like...
I did.
How about Bob Hope you even taught?
Well, Bob Windsor. I played golf with Bob once, not too well that particular time. I played with the Duke of Windsor.
Uh-huh.
I gave lessons to Jane Mansfield. Mm-hmm. I gave lessons to Marilyn, and I advised both of them to get back in the golf cart and stick to sex.
Is that what you told them both?
Yes, because golfers, I said, you're never going to be. So they took my advice.
It was really good.
I played with all the pros. I played with Errol Flynn. He was really fun to play with.
Every woman's idol, right? Mm-hmm. And they loved him. Why did women love Errol Flynn so?
He was flamboyant. He was gorgeous. He was a liver. Like a drink.
What does she not see in a man? What makes her tick in a man? Because you've seen the best. You've been out with the best. You've been around Hollywood for many years, all the world. What does it tick you in a man?
Well, I like a really sweet, quiet, unassuming man. And that's what Fred was when I met him. That's what Clark Gable was. That's what Elvis Presley was very shy. Unfortunately, that's probably not the kind I should have, though. I probably should have the ones with the gold chain and the open shirt and the comedian type, because I like to laugh. And none of these people that I'm speaking of have any sense of humor. No, they didn't. And I love a sense of humor.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about Hollywood today, Jeanne Carmen?
I think it's it's insane.
Hollywood today.
Don't you think it's insane? The glamour is gone. There's no
living in Hollywood is like going through a sewer and a glass bottom.
You're right.
For me, I'm sorry to tell you, this is what I think of Hollywood today. And
I haven't smoked it since, not before.
But there really wasn't a lot of drugs.
I didn't know about it at all.
Yeah.
If it was there, I was never involved in it, never was asked to take it.
Sinatra. No, that's your love. Come on, you and Sinatra. You've dated secretly. Up openly.
Openly, secretly, and otherwise.
You're his lady. Actually, one of his ladies.
For a long time. 7 years off and on.
7 years of Frank Sinatra.
Off and on, yes.
What kind of a guy.
Well, Frank, to me, was wonderful. He was warm and sweet and cuddly and nice. I guess he had a bad side. But I never saw it.
Never saw
him? No. In fact, but I was worse to him than he was to me. I mean, he was never mean to me. I was...
What do you mean you were worse?
I was naughty. One time we were having dinner with 12 people, a lunch, I guess, at his restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
And Peter Lawford was sitting next to me, and I got bored. I said to Peter, isn't this the boringest bloody party you've ever been to? And he said, yes, what shall we do about it? I said, I don't know. He said, go to the bathroom, meet me outside.
Uh-huh.
I did. We took Frank's limo, went to the Peter's Beach House, and guess how long it took me to get back with Frank that time when he came out and found out I had left. about him with this limo.
I see why Sinatra loves you so. Well, get a close-up of that. Look, Keene, Carmen, good God, you must accept Hollywood. Accept the whole town, really. Look at this. You're beautiful.
Well, if I hadn't been so shy, I could have done a lot of distracting.
You call yourself shy?
Not now.
How would a woman call herself shy looking like that?
Well, showing it and doing it is two different stories.
Was Marilyn shy?
Yes.
Was Marilyn Monroe really shy?
She was very afraid. She was very insecure. We both had a problem of being afraid, being insecure about our looks. Most of the time we thought we were ugly.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Even today, if I get a close-up of my profile, I'll be depressed for hours.
Marilyn thought she was ugly.
There were times, only when she was totally, completely, and utterly made up into Marilyn Monroe, and she was Norma Jean, she thought she was ugly.
Was she a lonely little child?
Very lonely.
Like a little child?
Very lonely.
Was she?
A lonely older child, a lonely lady.
How about the Kennedys? Tell me about the Kennedys. She loved Bobby?
I said, yes. She said, would you like me to help you? And I said, yes. So she helped me do my scene, and we had a couple of wines, and then it came time for us to go in, and we went via the bathroom.
Right.
I went into the, you know what, and she stayed outside. When I came out, I didn't see her, and I thought, well, there was a blonde standing there trying to imitate Marilyn Monroe.
Right.
Oh, my God, I could do better than this.
Uh-huh.
So I go out, and just as I open the door, she goes, Jean, and I look around, and I said, oh, my God, I don't believe it. I've been sitting with Marilyn Monroe all this time and had no idea. So she giggled, and we went inside. And from that day on, we were the best of friends. Best of friends. Talked all the time.
Did she have a lot of girlfriends?
No. She didn't trust women.
Well, how did she trust you, Jean?
Well, one of the reasons is that because I sat there, I liked her, we got along, she liked me, and I liked her without knowing it was Marilyn Monroe.
Did she have problems at that time? When you were in New York, living at the Actors Studio, working and all that?
Well, she always had problems. It depends on what kind of problems we're talking about. Men problems?
No, life. Just life. Not just...
She was always... life was hard for her. Very complicated. Very. She was very complicated. Depressed and... she had happy moments and sad moments.
But then you came to Hollywood. You've been Universal's and MGM, starlet. I mean, you are a true starlet. Hollywood stars. That's what they call the Hollywood stars. And you, three outlaws. Tell me about the three outlaws with Bruce Bennett.
That was my first movie.
This was your first
movie? And the only thing I can remember about that is my love in the thing had to eat a big piece of chicken.
Uh-huh.
And then after we kissed, then we had to kiss madly, and the director said, cut and don't print.
Uh-huh.
I said, why? He said, because you've got a big piece of chicken on your lip. That was my introduction to love scenes.
The Macambolins, Ceros, Trocadero. Tell me about Hollywood those days. Jeannie Carmen must have gone to the clubs.
That was pretty wild. I once rented Ceros to give a birthday party for my brother and I. We're twins. And I had every celebrity there that is imaginable. I had lots of dates. I dated Hugh O'Brien and Frank Sinatra and Elvis Presley and...
Ah, but Les Clark. Tell me about Les Clark. I mean,
well,
tell me something. Growing up in Texas, moved to New York. From Texas to New York.
It was quite a switch from Texas.
Uh-huh.
And I was 16 at the time.
You went to see visit a cousin of yours.
I did. Mm-hmm.
And backstage, burlesque, was it?
One day after I arrived there, she was visiting a friend on the set of a Broadway show, Burlesque, with Bert Lahr. And Bert walked, I was sitting in a seat, and he walked up and he said, "Are you in show business?" And before I could open up my mouth, the guy next to me said, "Yes, she is."
Who was that?
That was, he became my husband. But anyway, he said, "Do you dance?" And the guy said, "Yes, she can dance." Well, the guy that had to teach me to dance quit the business.
Uh-huh.
Believe me, I couldn't dance, but I did go in the chorus, and then he asked me to do a featured part in the show.
Uh-huh.
And then I went on to do another show with
him. Oh, God, he kept good.
That's aging me, isn't it?
No, it's not aging you.
No, aging.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
But you came to Hollywood, one of Universal's top starlets and all that starlet type of things. What happened in Hollywood at Universal's? Tell me.
Well, in between that, I was a golfer. I was a trick shot golf artist. So that's what brought me to Hollywood.
Uh-huh.
I had to get out of Hollywood. I went to Vegas first, and I played a lot of golf there. There was a lot of betting going on. And then somebody saw me and said, "You should go to Hollywood."
Oh, is that what it was?
And I did.
Uh-huh.
And
you were a golf tripper?
Trick shot golfer.
What's
yeah.
that?
Hit a ball off somebody's face. I could hit a flagpole, one out of three, 150 yards out. I could hook it, slice it,
really?
Do just about anything with it I wanted to.
You've been playing golf all your life?
No, played 6 months, and I was taken out on a golf, inside a golf school in New York.
Right.
Then I was taken out on a golf course, and I shot an 80 from the men's tee, played barefoot, and didn't know how to tee up the ball.
Looking at you, how did these men play golf by looking at you? Have you upset them? Their game at all?
That was good for me.
Was it good for you?
Very good for me.
Beautiful. God.
Usually it was hard for them to play with me.
Really?
Conrad Hilton quit on the third hole. Most men would quit by the ninth hole.
I want to see what happened at Universal when you came here to be one of the Hollywood top stars. I would like them to see a picture of you right now.
Well, I did a lot of TV. And
I know. Let's see a picture. There you are. Good God, you're beautiful. Deanna Dores. Look at you.
Anita I did Ekberg. A picture with Deanna
did
Dores.
You?
Yeah.
Look at this. Is that Anita Ekberg or not? Good. Universal must have loved you. This was in the 50s, right?
Yes, it was.
Oh, look how beautiful you are. Oh. And Marilyn Monroe and all these people. Tell me about Marilyn Monroe when you worked.
Well,
I met her in New York.
I met Marilyn in New York. I had been going to the Actors Studio for quite a while. I was studying with Lee Strasberg.
Right.
I even studied with Lee in his home before he even got a studio.
Really?
And one day I had to do a scene, and I was real nervous, so I stopped by a little bar next to the studio.
Uh-huh.
So I look around, I think, I'm not going to get next to a guy that's going to aggravate me. I'll get near someone that is not going to bother me. So I look over, and here's this girl with it. Black hair and the glasses and looked very subdued and very cute. I thought, I'll sit by her, which I did.
Right.
So she looked at me and she said, "Are you an actress?" And I said, "Yes."
Uh-huh.
She said, are you working with the Actors Studio? I
right.
said, "Yes." She said, "Are you doing a scene?"
I would like to park her up the tree. Come on.
Unfortunately, I guess I broke up Mike and Lana's marriage, unbeknownst to me. We were in Kanab, Utah. It was very boring there. I was living in his house. We never had an affair, but we became very good friends. We fished together. We were together.
Maybe
we
heard bought you're sitting there telling me never had an affair or
not with
just friends.
Just friends.
Really? Like what? Like such good friends. Like Lex Barker. I mean, Lana Turner was married to him.
I know.
Wait, he was he confident with you or what?
Oh, yes. He liked Lana. And they got along, but he wasn't, and he loved her, but he wasn't in love with her. And she was so busy all the time, he really couldn't tell his problems to her. So, but we were like two kids.
Uh-huh.
But she wouldn't go fishing with him.
Was it tough for a girl like you to be a starlet here in Hollywood at that time?
Because
you're so beautiful and sexy and casting couches and all that. Were
well,
a lot of casting couches at that time?
I never had that. A lot of girls said they did, but I was so naive that if they approached me, I probably didn't realize it, and I appeared to be aloof. So, because of my shyness.
Why would you? Oh, you're shy.
Yeah, I was very shy.
So,
but as covering my shyness, I didn't talk. I just looked. I walked around. I didn't go to many parties, actually. I was a one-on-one person, and I wasn't always at the parties. So, I would do my reading, and I would go.
So
I imagine I got approached without realizing it.
Was Hollywood tough then for a girl?
Not for me.
It wasn't.
I never went for a part, never left for a part. I just got them. I would be sitting someplace or hear about it from someone.
Was there a lot of drugs those days?
I don't remember any. I had drugs only once, and it was with the king of Belgium that I met. I shouldn't be saying that probably. And I met him getting in Dallas, getting on a plane. The red carpet was out. I was late for the plane. They were rolling out the carpet. I said, wait for me.
Uh-huh.
So I got on the plane, went to the back, and there was the king, and I had no car. I'm waiting at the airport, and he said, I'll take you home. He first took me by Luella Parsons at a party. Then we went to his hotel. Another person was with me. And there we smoked pot for the first time. I have